Hello, thanks for tuning in to the Turfway Park Report for Saturday, March 18th, 2017. Nine races on tap for you. The Poly Track, as always, is fast. Tonight's first race is a claiming event for Three Olds and Up, which have never won three. The claiming tag, $5,000 for the distance, 1 mile. Field of six set to go with the morning line favorite, number five, Civil Dispute, with Perry Hoots. And they are racing. French Badge broke well, but it's Devadud who has the most speed. Civil Dispute will prompt the pace from the three wide side. These three are length in front of Aeroscrito, who is fourth down along the inside. Tizon is next, and Thundercloud, checking into the first turn, is at the back of the pack. Compact field, though. They're only six lengths from top to bottom, and the tearaway leader, though, is Devadud at 26-1. Takes him on by the 6 furlong marker, three in front of Civil Dispute, who has deferred to second. Tizon against the rail, third, covered up to the outside by Aeroscrito, who is fourth, about seven off the pace. And then a link for the back to French Badge, who broke sharp but has been taken in hand. One in front of Thundercloud, who has at the back of the pack. Up the backside they go, 4.5 furlongs still to travel. First quarter, 24-3. And Devadut's the one to catch. Devadut by the half mile pole. The lead is now six. Civil Dispute races just to the outside of Tizon, who is second and third. Then a link for the back. Aeroscrito is fourth, a length in front. French Badge is being asked to quicken, and now Thundercloud has switched to the middle of the track and starting to close in through a half in 48-2. Devadut still up top, but coming back to the field. It's Civil Dispute in the middle, who is second. Aeroscrito revs up on the three wide side. Now French Badge being put to the test, and Thundercloud is moving right with that one as the field covered by about 4 lengths as they run to the top of the stretch. Anyone has a chance as they straighten away for the stretch drive, and Aeroscrito emerges with the lead. Aeroscrito off the turn in front by a length. Civil Dispute right to his inside, pestering down along the inside. Tizon, French Badge is no better than third as they're in the deep stretch. It's Aeroscrito. Civil Dispute will not go away. It's going to be one of these two, but now as they race down towards the wire, Aeroscrito is edging clear, and Aeroscrito wins the opener. Civil Dispute was in a photo there with Tizon for the second spot. French Badge was fourth. Running time 1:39.4. Number six, Aeroscrito, gets the job done on just 9 days rest here for the Equinox Incorporated Eduardo Caramori Trains Abel Lascano up top. The winner, 720, 380, 260. Second to five, Civil Dispute. Third, number three, Tizon. Fourth to two, French Badge. Exact to $20.20. The Tri, $46.60. The Super, $146.60. Running time, 1:39.4. Tonight's second race, a claimant event for horses which have never won three races, the distance 6 furlongs. Jockey change on the morning line favorite, number two, Harlan's Howling, to Alonzo Quinones. They are racing. Quick start for Ambidextrous Alex, also Wise Beginning for Amazon King, and between those two goes Neighborhood Cat. Robinito's up pace presence on the four wide side, about 2.5 lengths off the lead, then a length and a half to Harlan's Howling, the favorite, as one horse beat, and that is Rake It In at the back of the pack. 7 lengths from top to bottom. They're just outside the half-mile pole. And up top, it's Amazon King, who shows the way. On the inside, Neighborhood Cat. Something amiss. Ambidextrous Alex blowing the turn there out in about the 10 path. And here comes Robinito splitting the top trio there. Harlan's Howling's just in behind that cluster. And then a link for the back to Rake It In as they round that far turn. Just outside the quarter-mile pole, it's Neighborhood Cat still shows it up top from Robinito. Up the inside, here comes Rake It In from absolutely last, and Amazon King, and blowing the turn still, Ambidextrous Alex, as they straighten away for the stretch drive. Neighborhood Cat on top. Here's Harlan's Howling attacking to the outside. Rake It In continued, try to squeeze through along the fence or inside the final furlong, and Harlan's Howling has gained the upper hand, and Harlan's Howling's going to win it here. Harlan's Howling, his third win from 5 starts over the Poly, wins it by a length and a half. Robinito was in a photo with Rake It In, then came Neighborhood Cat in 1:10.4. Number two, Harlan's Howling, as the favorite, delivers here in race two. Harlan's Howling picks up his third victory over the surface for owner Mark Breen, trainer Mike Maker, and Alonzo Quinones, the winning jockey. The winner, 420, 260, 220. Second to six, Robinito. Third was number five, Rake It In, and fourth to three, Neighborhood Cat. Exact to 2180, the Tri, 3480. The Double, $15. Super, $276.60. Tonight's third race, a claimant event for four-year-olds and up, which have not won three races in a full calendar year. The distance, 1 mile, scratch the three, malleable. Morning line favorite, number four, Bell by The Ridge. And they are racing. Mr. Unanonymous broke sharply, as did Twice Mike. Get Me Out of Here, Seamus came away racing in third. Belle by the Ridge, the 10-year-old, came away racing fourth, about a length and a half off the lead now. And then a separation of two to Brother Stewart, who's way out wide. And Most Wanted tucks in, saves all the ground on the run the first turn. Seven lengths from top to bottom here, midpoint through the opening turn. Mr. Unanonymous and Perry Ute show the way by two. Get Me Out of Here, Seamus, tracking in the pocket spot. Belle by the Ridge covered up in third by Twice Mike, who is fourth. Then a link for the back, Most Wanted is fifth. And then a link to Brother Stewart at the back of the pack. They pass the 5/8 mile pole. First quarter almost in 25 seconds flat. Slow fractions for Mr. Unanonymous, who heads up the backside, still in front by three. Get Me Out of Here, Seamus, continues to track in second. Belle by the Ridge has shook clear now in third, racing out in the clear about the four path now and closing in a length in front of Most Wanted, who is fourth. Now going for a run, there goes Twice Mike in search of three wins in a row, cut loose by Kaiser and really closing in on the top trio there as they took the half in 48 and 4/5 seconds. Mr. Unanonymous has been on a clear and uncontested lead, but company's coming. Belle by the Ridge, the favorite, is right in the middle as Twice Mike revs up on the three wide side. Get Me Out of Here, Seamus is fourth, Most Wanted fifth, and Brother Stewart can't see them all. Three quarters, 1:13 and two, and they're on their way home. And now Belle by the Ridge, the class dropper, tries to go on by, but Mr. Unanonymous will not go away along the rail. These two a length in front of Twice Mike as they go by the 16th pole. And now Belle by the Ridge has gained the upper hand, but Twice Mike is lunging up to the outside. One final surge. Twice Mike, Belle by the Ridge, Twice Mike got there. Now on a three race win streak, Belle by the Ridge was next in 1:38 flat. Number six, Twice Mike, needed every inch of the racetrack to run down Belle by the Ridge, but got up right on the square to get his third straight victory here at the track for the Southwest Racing Stable and Gennaro Garcia. Chelsea Kaiser was up top for the winning ride. Twice Mike was worth 620, 260, 220. Second the four, Belle by the Ridge. Third the five, Mr. Unanonymous. And fourth the one, Get Me Out of Here, Seamus. Exactly 1180, the try, 2570. The double, 1540. The super, $157. And the pick three was worth $30.20. Running time, 1:38 flat. Tonight's fourth race, a claiming event for the fillies and mares to go a mile and a 16th. Rodney Prescott rides the four, Ola Gatita. Scratch the seven, Annie Indy. Morningline favorite number two, Fly Away Kitten, for trainer Mike Maker. And they're off. Fast start for the favorite Flyaway Kitten, but it's Ola Gatita who will come to press her to the outside. Tenacious Sally's going to try to tuck in there in third against the fence. Blaine the Dream right to her outside north of Eden. And Don't Get Even is last of the sextet as they head into the turn. And it's the favorite Flyaway Kitten on that tearaway lead. She's in front by about 3.5. Ola Gatita tracking in the second spot. Tenacious Sally away in third, about 5.5 off of pace. And a length in front of the pair of Blaine the Dream and North of Eden. And Don't Get Even is at the back of the pack. Must be about 12 lengths off the lead as they straighten up the backstretch. 5/8 of a mile to go here. Flyaway Kitten up top through some fast fractions here. 23-3 the opening quarter. Flyaway Kitten now trying to come back to Jimenez there. She's 5 in front of Ola Gatita. Right to her outside, there's Tenacious Sally. She overtakes second as a half mile up on the board, 47. In 1/5 second. Flyaway Kitten past the half mile pole. The lead's now just 3.5. Tenacious Sally has moved into second. Ola Gatita is third. There goes North of Eden up to the outside in fourth. Then a separation of about three and a half lengths back to Blame the Dream. As they continue to round the turn, they're 3/8 of a mile from home. Flyaway Kitten now confronted to the outside by Tenacious Sally. North of Eden has moved to the three wide side as they're outside the quarter mile pole. Flyaway Kitten on a tenuous lead here. Tenacious Sally attacks to the outside. North of Eden is third. Down along the inside, Olga Tita, Blame the Dream kicks to the outside as they have an 1/8 of a mile left to go. Tenacious Sally trying to get by, but Flyaway Kitten is tenacious as well on the inside. These two match strides as they're outside the 16th pole, but now Tenacious Sally up to the outside. Flyaway Kitten will not go away. These two dispute it all the way down to the wire, and Tenacious Sally gets there. Flyaway Kitten a game second, North of Eden third, Blame the Dream fourth, 145-4. Number five, Tenacious Sally, wears down the pace-setting favorite and gets up to win for owner Darlene Bryce and Chip Brownfield, Orlando Mojica, with that rousing ride. Tenacious Sally, $12.80 for $23. Second number two, Flyaway Kitten. Third number three, North of Eden. And fourth the one, Blame the Dream. Exacta, $33.20. The try, $57.80. The double, $79.40. The super, $201 even. And the pick three, $76.20. Running time, 1:45-4. Tonight's fifth race is an allowance optional claiming event for the fillies and mares. They'll go 5.5 furlongs. Field of 9, but no program changes. Morning line favorite number 4, Near Shore with Rut Prescott.
And they're off. Fast start from Mischievous Cat, also a wise beginning for Bayshore Drive. There goes Our Magician up the inside. Rhapsody Gist is next. Right to her outside comes Near Shore. And Do I Dare right in the thick of it, too. 4.5 off the lead. Then comes Jersey Chaser. The two back markers are Devit Image and the favorite, Rule Like Cleopatra, is last. But she's only 5 lengths off the lead, and she's really moving now as they head into the far turn. 3 across the track. Our Magician to the inside. Mischievous Cat right sandwiched in the middle to the outside. Bayshore Drive. These three now match strides as they pass the 3/8 pole. Here's Do I Dare with a 4-wide bid. There goes a favorite cut loose. She's going to have to go about 6 wide as they run to the top of the lane. Near Shore may be the danger if she can get through as they run to the top of the stretch. On the inside, Our Magician. There's Mischievous Cat in the middle. Bayshore Drive, and there goes the favorite, Rule Like Cleopatra, roaring off the turn right on by the 8th pole. Rule Like Cleopatra opening up with each and every stride by the 16th pole. Rule Like Cleopatra now on a 4-race win streak. She wins drawing away, and at the wire she stops the timer in a fast 103.3, just 3/5 off the track record for Rule Like Cleopatra.
Number 5, Rule Like Cleopatra. Another dominant victory here. Her 4th straight at the track. Just 3/5 off the track record, winning race 5 for owner Casey Garrett Farm. Doug Danner, the winning trainer, and Jack Gilligan once again aboard for the winning ride. The winner, 380, 260, 220. Second, number 8, Bayshore Drive. Third was number 9, Jersey Chaser. There was a dead heat for 4th between number 3, Our Magician, and the 7, Mischievous Cat. Exacta, 12.20. The Try, 26.30. The Double, $39. The Superfecta ending with the 3, $568.40. Superfecta ending with the 7, $146.80. The Pick 5, $131.55. And the Pick 4, $169.50. Tonight's sixth race is a claiming event for 3-year-olds and up, which have never won 2. The claiming tag, 30 down to $20,000. 6.5 furlongs the distance. Morning line favorite number 3, Gaultier with Alonzo Quiñones.
They are racing, and Noble Warrior caught a flyer quick into stride down towards the inside. There goes Move the Chains. Then a link for the back, Gaultier came away racing in the 3rd position. Right to that one's inside comes Malibu Blues, then Tavern on the Crow. Compact field as they leave the chute and they straighten up on the main track. And up top, it's Move the Chains, shows the way by just about a nose now. Right to the outside is Infant Midnight and Tavern on the Crow. On the 3-wide side, there's Noble Warrior. Then a link for the back, Gaultier, the favorite, has 1 horse beat, and that's Malibu Blues at the back of the pack. The first quarter mile timed in 23.25. There goes Tavern on the Crow. Tavern on the Crow leads him in the far turn by about a length. Move the Chains. Racing in the 2nd position, about a length for the back. Coming on the outside, here comes Noble Warrior. Infant Midnight in with a shot. And Gaultier, all dressed up with nowhere to go. His last was going to need some racing room here as they're just outside the quarter mile pole. The half mile, 47 seconds flat, and it's Infinite Midnight cut loose by Corey Orme off the turn in front by a length and a half. Move the Chains, grinding away along the rail. That's all for Tavern on the Crow. Here's Gaultier switched out off cover as they straighten for the stretch drive. 1/8 of a mile left to go. Infinite Midnight drawing away here by the 16th pole. Infinite Midnight well prepared off that long layoff by Brian Michael. Infinite Midnight, no doubt about it. Move the Chains was 2nd, Gaultier was 3rd, and Tavern on the Crow 4th.
Number 4, Infinite Midnight. Impressive in victory here for Alan Tenenbaum. Brian Michael, the winning trainer, and Corey Orme up top for the winning ride. Number 4, Infinite Midnight, well prepared off that layoff. Bet down to 5-2 and returns $7, $462.40. Second, number 2, Move the Chains, the other Brian Michael trainee. Third, number 3, Gaultier. And 4th to 5, Tavern on the Crow. Exacta, $75.80. The $1 try, $78.50. The Daily Double, $15.80. The Super, $713.80. The Pick 3, $72. Even running time, 1:16 4/5. Tonight's 7th race, a claimed event for 4-year-olds and up, which have not won a race in the last 6 months. 6.5 furlongs is the distance. Morning line favorite to the outside, number 8, Top Gato in Gabe Lagunas.
They are off. Top Gato broke sharp, clearly perfection, quick into stride as well. Storm and Greeley, and there goes Perry Utes with Union Label. as they leave the chute behind them and straighten up on the back stretch. It's Union Label shows the way. City Classic to the outside. Storm and Greeley races third. The top three covered by a length. Down on the inside, Shady Creek is next. Top Gato, the favorite, is fifth. Out in the clear, 4.5 off the lead. And a length in front of Union Label. Kate's Forest is next. And at the back of the pack, Stroke. Up the backside they go. They're 8 lengths from top to bottom. They pass the half-mile pole. First quarter, 23 2/5 seconds. There goes Storm and Greeley with that early middle move. Takes the lead on to the turn in front by a length. Down along the inside, Pace Any, Union Label is next. City Classics third. Top Gato looking to pounce on the top trio from fourth through from between horses. Comes a Shady Creek as they run around the turn, the half, 47 seconds flat. And Top Gato has the lead, but he's had to work hard and he's been wide throughout. Here comes Shady Creek, switches to the center of the track. Storm and Greeley as they straighten away for the stretch drive. Four across the track. Here's Shady Creek looking to come over the top. Storm and Greeley still grinding along the rail. Top Gato, the favorite, in between those two. Just outside the 16th pole. And Shady Creek forging to the front. Top Gato still grinding away and plugging along the inside. But Shady Creek and up Bell Lascano wins it by half a side. Top Gato was second, tight for third between Clearly Perfection and Storm and Greeley running time, 118-1.
Number 4, Shady Creek, pulls the slight upset here in race 7 for owner Barry King and Jay Wilkinson, the trainer. Abel Lascano up top for his second victory on the night's card. Shady Creek, 28-47-40 and 4/60. Second, the 8, Top Gato. Third, number 5, Clearly Perfection. And fourth, the 6, Storm and Greeley. Exacta, $100.80. The Tri, $383 even. Daily Double, $118. The Super, $2,114.60. Pick 3, $218.70. Running time for race 7, 118-1. Tonight's 8th race is an allowance optional claimant event to go 1 mile for the 3-year-olds and upward. Scratch number 4, Wear the Mask. Morning line favorite number 2, Normandy Crossing with Perry Utes.
And they're off. The starter caught him in a perfect line. It's Normandy Crossing who's sending on out. Impassable Canyon away in good order towards the fence. Out 3 wide comes 4 in the morning. Right to his inside is Smarty Kitten. The favorite, Calm Pacific, came away racing into 5th position and last away early is Tiz 2 as the field heads into the clubhouse turn. 6.5 lengths from front to back and Normandy Crossing's the one to catch. Normandy Crossing, the pace setter, goes by the 6-furlong marker. The lead just a half length now as 4 in the morning, a bit rank out to the outside between those two races in Passable Canyon. These three in a line as they straighten up the backstretch. There's a separation of 4 or 5 lengths back to Smarty Kitten. To the inside is Tiz 2 and the favorite, Calm Pacific, is last. 4.5 furlongs still to race. First quarter mile time 24-1. So fairly fast fractions for Normandy Crossing, who shows the way by a length as they pass the half mile pole in 47-4. Solid tempo being set by Normandy Crossing. Impassable Canyon in the pocket spot there in second. 4 in the morning. Bids up to the outside third. Now Calm Pacific's underway from the back of the pack. Smarty Kitten's towards his inside. And Tiz 2 is underway as well. 3/8 of a mile still to go. Normandy Crossing has led every step of the way. The whip comes out on Impassable Canyon. That's all for 4 in the morning. Here's Calm Pacific revving up. Tiz 2 taking the overland route, and Smarty Kitten rides the rail through 3/4, 1:11-4. And Normandy Crossing, through those fast fractions, is still finding by the 3/16 pole. Normandy Crossing up top. Impassable Canyon to the outside. Now Calm Pacific has dead aim on Normandy Crossing, and Calm Pacific up to the outside. Normandy Crossing digging down deep. Impassable Canyon won't go away. They're in the final 4 furlongs. And Calm Pacific gets there by a length in the end. Tight for second between Impassable Canyon and Pace Setting Normandy Crossing. And Smarty Kitten was fourth, 137-2.
Number 7, Calm Pacific, was last early but stormed home down the center of the track to get up for his second straight victory here at Turfway. Number 7, Calm Pacific, owned and trained by Grant Hoffman's, Alvin Jimenez up top for the winning ride. Number 7, Calm Pacific, 420, 240, and 210. Second, the pace setter, number 2, Normandy Crossing. Third, the 1, Impassable Canyon. And fourth, the 5, Smarty Kitten. Exacta, $10. The Tri, $36.20. The Daily Double, $103.80. The Super, $57.20. The Pick 3, $258. Running time for the 1 mile, 137-2. Tonight's 9th race is a maiden claimant event for the maiden 3-year-olds and up. The claiming tag, $5,000. The distance, 6.5. Jockey change for the 1, Yates Running Wild to Williams New Pack. Scratch the 7, Casey's Colbert. Jockey change for the 10, Numbers Never Lie to Petey Prentice. The morning line favorite, number 3, Back Beach Road with Alberto Pusak.
They are racing. Smokey Mon came out running, quick and distraught as well. Hustled up, there goes Dear Patricia. Up on the outside, Numbers Never Lie, War Venture, congrats to Kukos. Joining that cluster is Back Beach Road. Through from the inside, races Yates Running Wild, then comes Catskill, Separation of Four to Ideal City, and the back marker at the back of the pack is Furious Spot. Up the backside they go. On the outside, it's Numbers Never Lie, through a quarter and 23 seconds flat. Through from between horses, there goes Smokey Mon. Dear Patricia is trying to check out of that spot there. Looping up on the three wide side comes Catskill. As the field enters the far turn, it's Numbers Never Lie, and Petey Prentice show the way up top. Up on the outside, here comes a congrats to Kukos. Down on the inside, Smokey Mon. And then still running on from the back, Catskill is fourth as they wind their way around the turn. Half mile, 46 and 2. And Numbers Never Lie for Emery. Brinklin's the one to catch. Numbers Never Lie off the turn in front by a length. Whip comes out on Dear Patricia. Also Smokey Mon. Down the stand side, here comes Ideal City from the back of the pack. And all of a sudden, the Indiana bred Ideal City just went right on by outside the 16th pole. Ideal City opening up into stretch. Late on the scene, Back Beach Road, down the center, comes congrats to Kukos, Ideal City, and Albin Jimenez wins the nightcap by four, photo for second. Number five, Ideal City, off that long layoff, well prepared by Tim Burke, gets the job done here in the nightcap. Ideal City breaks maiden for owner Teresa Burke, Albin Jimenez with his second victory on the card. Ideal City, $15, $864.20. Second three, Back Beach Road, third 12, congrats to Kukos. Finishing fourth was number four, Catskill, and fifth, the 10, Numbers Never Lie. No winners in the high five, carry over into Thursday's card, better than $4,300. The exact is $68.20, the 50 cent try, $60.95. The late double, $36.40, the super, $886.40, the pick three, $370.70, and the pick four, $830.65. Running time for the 6 1/2 furlongs, 118 and 3. Well, that wraps it up for this Saturday edition of the Turfway Park Report. Live racing returns next Thursday with a first post of 6:15. On behalf of the video department and myself here, we thank you for tuning in. This has been the Turfway Park Report.